بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله نحمد ونستعين ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا وسيئات اعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. كان السلف الصالح يلقن الاولاد سيره النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، يعني مثل ما تعلم انت الفاتحه والتشهد هو يعلم السيرة، يقول له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هو محمد بن عبد الله ولد بمكة كذا. نعم،
السلف and the Sahaba they used to verbally teach their children the seerah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Just as you learn and teach Surah Al-Fatiha verbally, the Salaf, they used to verbally teach their children the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they used to teach them that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is Muhammad ibn Abdullah and he was born in Mecca and like this.
نعم، حتى ينشأ هذا الصغير على طريقة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And they used to do this so that this young child, he grows up upon the method of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, traversing the path of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
نعم، أنا أريد كل واحد منكم يذكر لي شيء أثر فيه من سيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أثر فيه.
يعني نعم، أثر فيه هو في سلوكي، في عبادتي مثلا. نعم.
So I want each one of you to mention some aspect from the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam which had a personal effect or impact in your life.
نعم.
Brothers, إخوة, if you sit down inshallah, the books are there. Just sit down, listen to the lesson, and then afterwards the books are there inshallah.
نعم. يعني يقول عندما خرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لدعوة أهل الطائف وآذوه وأرسلوا عليه السفهاء والصغار، وهذا كان أشد ما لقي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، ومع هذا صبر عليه الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
So the brother mentioned the story of Taif, meaning when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he went to Taif to call them to Islam, and the people of Taif, they rejected him. And not only did they reject him, but they ordered their young and their foolish to hurt and harm the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this was the most severe trial or test which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam faced. And yet, he sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he remained patient.
نعم.
أحسن الله عليكم شيخ. حسن الخلق، الخلق مع عائشة رضي الله عنها.
حسن خلق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مع زوجاته. نعم.
And also, the beautiful manners that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had when interacting with his wives.
كان عليه الصلاة والسلام في خدمة أهله.
And that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was always in the service of his family.
وقال خيركم خيركم لأهله وأنا خيركم لأهلي.
And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he used to say that the best of you are those who are best to their families, and I am the best amongst you to my family.
نعم. فكان عليه الصلاة والسلام يقوم بشؤونه، يعني الأشياء التي تخصه هو يقوم بها عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, those matters or those tasks which are related to him and were his responsibility, he used to fulfill them.
نعم.
Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, half of his life, more than half, in Mecca, he used to say something like that, قولوا لا إله إلا الله.
أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قضى نصف حياته في مكة داعيا قولوا لا إله إلا الله.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم 23 سنة كان عليه الصلاة والسلام نبيا ورسولا. نعم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he lived 23 years as a prophet and a messenger.
فرضت عليه الصلوات المفروضة الخمس قبل الهجرة بثلاث سنين.
And the five obligatory prayers, they were legislated upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 3 years before he migrated to Al-Madinah.
منذ أن بعث إلى أن مات وهو يدعو للتوحيد وينذر عن الشرك.
And since or from the beginning of the time of his prophethood to his death, he continued calling the people to Tawheed and warning them against the shirk.
حتى وهو في مرض الموت في فراش الموت يحذر من الشرك عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And even when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was in his final illness from which he died, and he was in his deathbed, he would be warning the people against shirk.
نعم.
صلح
الحديبية.
صلح الحديبية. نعم.
نعم. The treaties at الحديبية.
أمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الصحابة أن يتحللوا. لأنه لا يدخل إلى مكة. لابد يتحللوا من الحج من العمرة. نعم.
The Treaty of Hudaybiyah, when the Sahaba, they were going towards Mecca wearing the Ihram in order to perform Umrah, and they were prevented from doing so. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he ordered his companions to come out of Ihram because they are no longer entering into Mecca.
ما تحرك أحد.
And nobody moved.
ما صنعوا شيء.
They did nothing.
دخل عليه الصلاة والسلام على أم سلمة رضي الله عنها.
And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went to his wife Umm Salama radiallahu anha.
وَشَكَى لَهَا مَا لَغِيَ مَنَ النَّاسِ أَنَّهُ أَمَرَهُمْ وَمَا صَنَعُوا شَيْءٍ. نعم.
And he complained to his wife Umm Salama radiallahu anha regarding the reaction of the people that he has ordered them to do something and nobody has moved.
فَقَالَتْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم أمرته أن يخرج ويحلق يعني يطبق هذا عمليا فعندما خرج عليه الصلاة والسلام وتحلل حلق رأسه حلق الصحابة كلهم رضوان الله عليهم نعم
And so أم سلمة رضي الله عنها his wife she advised him to go out in front of the people and shave his hair meaning to demonstrate this physically in front of everybody. And so when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did so, then everybody else followed him.
فيه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يستشير الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم. نعم.
And from the benefits of this story is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he used to seek counsel and advice from his companions.
وأحيانا بعض الأزواج يقول أنا ما أسمع من زوجتي شيئا. ولا أخذ رأيها أصلاً. نعم.
And sometimes some husbands they say I'm not going to listen to anything from my wife. I'm not going to accept any of her opinions.
نعم. نعم. حج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حج واحدة فقط. نعم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he only performed one Hajj.
وسميت بحجة الوداع لأنه عليه الصلاة والسلام فيها كان كالمودع لهم يقول لهم لعلي لا ألقاكم بعدها عام هذا وبالفعل صلى بعد أن رجع عليه الصلاة والسلام بدأ به المرض وتوفي عليه الصلاة والسلام في شهر ربيع الأول نعم بعد الحج نعم
And this only Hajj which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم performed This is called Hajjatul Wida, the farewell pilgrimage. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he would bid people farewell and he would say, perhaps I will not meet you again after this year. And this is how it occurred. Because when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he returned to Al-Madinah after this Hajj, then slowly he became ill and this was the illness of his death.
Now. يقول أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كانت تصيبه مصائب كثيرة عليه الصلاة والسلام لكن لا تؤثر فيه بإذن الله نعم
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he was afflicted with many struggles and many calamities however these calamities would not impact him by the permission of Allah
ولد يتيما عليه الصلاة والسلام مات أبوه قبل أن يولد
He was born as an orphan, عليه الصلاة والسلام. His father died before he was born.
ماتت الأم بعد الولادة.
And then his mother also passed away a short while after his birth.
كان في كفالة جدي فمات الجد عبد المطلب.
And then he was taken under the care of his grandfather عبد المطلب. And then also عبد المطلب passed away.
ثم كان في كفالة عمي أبو طالب فمات أبو طالب وماتت الزوجة الحنون خديجة رضي الله عنها.
And then he was taken under the care of his uncle Abu Talib, and Abu Talib also passed away. And then his loving wife Khadija رضي الله عنها, she also passed away.
مات جميع أولاد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حياته إلا فاطمة رضي الله عنها. ماتت بعد موت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بستة أشهر تقريبا.
And all the children of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away during his lifetime. Except Fatima رضي الله عنها, his daughter, who died after his death by only 6 months approximately.
فهذه المصائب لم تؤثر فيه, لم تصد عن الدعوة, لم تؤثر في نفسيته عليه الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
And so these calamities and these afflictions one after the other, none of them had an impact upon the mental state of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. None of them stopped him fulfilling his da'wah.
نعم. من يذكر لي أولاد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
And who can mention for me the children of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
أنا لا أسأل عن فريق مانشستر.
هذا فريق نفسي.
ممكن لو أسأل مشكلة أجاوب. نعم، كم؟
إبراهيم.
إبراهيم؟
Who else?
لا تغشش أنت.
Said don't cheat.
آه. فاطمة، رقية، وزينب، تمام، وأم كلثوم، وإبراهيم، وعبد الله، والقاسم، هؤلاء السبعة.
So these seven are تمام. The children of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
طيب، أبو النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. تعال، نعم. عبد الله وجده. عبد المطلب وعمه أبو طالب كذلك حمزة رضي الله عنه. طيب.
The father of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, his name was Abdullah, and the grandfather of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, his name was عبد المطلب, and the uncle of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was Abu Talib and also حمزة رضي الله عنه.
نعم. هو ينتسب إلى إسماعيل ابن إبراهيم عليهما وعلى نبينا أفضل الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
And so the lineage of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it goes back to إسماعيل, the son of Ibrahim. May peace and salutation be upon them and upon our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
نعم. من يذكر لنا أشياء أثرت فيه من سيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Slandering
Elijah.
قصة الإفك أن أهل النفاق تكلموا في أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها. هم أرادوا بهذا الكلام في أبي بكر رضي الله عنه وفي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, ليس غرضهم عائشة فقط رضي الله عنها. نعم.
The slander which was made by the people of Nifaq, the people of hypocrisy against أم المؤمنين Aisha radiallahu anha. And they intended by this to slander Abu Bakr radiallahu anha, her father, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So the intended target was not Aisha radiallahu anha, rather it was her father Abu Bakr and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself.
هناك بيت من بيوت الأنصار قال الرجل لزوجته قال نحن نعتقد أن الله سبحانه وتعالى خص عائشة بأن تكون زوجة من زوجات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنا أعتقد ونحن نعتقد أن عائشة أفضل منك. قالت نعم. قال هل تفعلي أنت هذا الشيء الفاحش؟ قالت لا. قال إذا أنت لا تفعلين إذا عائشة من باب أولى. شهدوا ببراءة عائشة دون أن يروا شيئا. بماذا؟ لأنهم اعتقدوا أن الله سبحانه وتعالى لا يختار للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلا أفضل النساء. نعم، ونحن نعتقد أن الصحابة أمهات المؤمنين أفضل منا، إذا لابد أن لا نتكلم فيما شجر بينهم. نعم.
And when this occurred, there was a house amongst the houses of the Ansar, and the husband said to his wife that we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has chosen Aisha radiallahu anha to be the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said this to his wife. And he said, and so I believe, and we believe that Aisha radiallahu anha, she's better than you. And his wife replied, yes. So then he said, would you commit such an action, this fahisha, this indecency, would you do this? And she said, no. So he said, then it's impossible for you not to do this action, and then she who is better than you by your own admittance, for her to do this action. And, say, and so they knew that Aisha radiallahu anha was innocent of this without even knowing anything regarding the story. And similar when it comes to the Sahaba. So if we know and we admit and we appreciate that the Sahaba are better than us, then it's not possible for them to do those actions that we would refrain from. And for this reason, that confusion which occurred amongst the Sahaba alayhim radhiyallahu after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not permitted for us to delve into any of it.